This video will change the way you manage videos every day. Which is the most common kinds of video we see? Teams, meetings, recordings. Those are visible inside Teams. But do you know that behind the scenes, it uses a very sophisticated streaming software called Stream. It's a part of Microsoft 365. Teams meetings automatically record transcript as well. Go to the Teams recording, click open in Stream, and there you will see a very useful feature called Trim. Trim is not a great big thing, but very often meeting recordings have too much of unwanted stuff in the beginning and the end. Now you can trim. And trust me, it's not just useless. Some discussion which happens before or after the meeting actually starts can be dangerous. Now, other than meetings, what are the types of videos we do? Those could be training videos, software app training, or business policies, safety videos, reference videos, technical process videos. All of those videos do not have a transcript. So what is the best practice? Any video in any format, put it on Stream. Now you don't have to go to Stream. You put it on OneDrive, Teams, or SharePoint. It automatically uses Stream behind the scene. So upload the video, rename it properly, and then one extra step to be taken. Go to Video Settings, and there enable Transcript. Unfortunately, by default, transcript doesn't get generated. You have to go there and say generate. While generating, make sure the language is set correctly. Primary spoken language. Even if it is English, there are different types of English pronunciations, so choose the correct one. In my case, I'm going to choose English India. That increases the accuracy of transcript. Now, how long is it going to take? If it's a 1 hour video, transcript generation takes 1 hour. Once it is done, now you can use the transcript to quickly navigate the video. Look at the transcript, read it, click anywhere. The video will start playing from that point of time. But more important, you can search for a topic in the transcript and then it'll give you multiple timestamps. Click on the one which is of interest to you. And now you can learn from a video or refer to a video which you already know more effectively. Once transcript is generated, it can go one step further. It can generate chapters. So for long videos, there can be multiple topics created. So generate on, and then it'll automatically create chapters. In this case, it's a short video, so it generated one chapter. But if you want, go to any point in the video and say add chapter, give it a name, and done. What is the use of chapters? If someone is watching a long video, they can pick and choose where they want to go. Or if you want to share a topic, you can share a chapter with someone else. The transcript which is generated, you can download also and use it for other video tools like YouTube. Finally, all this is in the native version of Stream. On top of it, if you have Copilot, then it adds more features. You see Copilot button, open it. It opens a pane like all other apps. The simplest is summary. Long video, you are seeing it for the first time. First look at the summary and then jump to specific topics. Or you want to know action items. You want to know the key topics discussed. Issues, problems, FAQs, anything you ask Copilot, it is going to look at the transcript and give you whatever you wanted. And the last thing is, suppose I want to search for a topic. In this case, white tick mark. I could have searched in transcript, but then it'll just give me timestamps. Here I can give a more intelligent prompt saying, tell me where white tick mark is covered. And then it'll give me a better description with embedded timestamps. Much better than regular text-based search. So to recap, what is the best practice now? Any video goes into OneDrive, Teams, SharePoint, which means Stream. Any video, generate a transcript by setting the correct language. Create chapters if it is a long video. And teach the way to use the transcript and Copilot to all people who consume the video. The same video gives you better value. How do you create videos? Again, there are two ways. One is within Stream and one is a more sophisticated video editor called Clipchamp. I have both videos. Have a look at them before you go. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.